Ecamm fam, what's good y'all? This is Marshall Fox and today I got a quick one for you. I'm going to show you how to make a dope lower third like this one that you can use on your live streams with Ecamm. So this is an intermediate tutorial. We're going to be using Apple Motion, which is a $50 program, but we're going to use templates, okay? We're not going to be doing anything from scratch. And you can get these kinds of templates from places like Motion Array or Video Hive, but the template that I'm going to use today is from Envato Elements, all right? So go ahead and grab Apple Motion and let's get into it. All right, so the first thing that we need is a template to start from. So let's head over to Envato Elements, one of my favorite places. We're gonna select video templates from the top. Let's type in lower thirds, not turds. All right, go down to the left-hand side and let's filter this list and only show Apple Motion. If you have Final Cut Pro, you can check that off, but a lot of those are the same, to be honest. So they give you tons of different packs to choose from. Look at this one. This one looks cool. So you can preview it. So these are all of the lower thirds that come in this pack. So let's download this one. Let's grab a license for it, download. You can save it to your downloads folder. We'll unzip it. So the good thing is all of these packs, they come with instructions. Sometimes it's just a PDF. Sometimes it's a PDF and a movie. So you can take a look at it. So just read the instructions and that's it. We'll see you next time. No, I'm playing. So if you only have Final Cut Pro installed and not Motion, you'll want to install it at this location. But if you have Motion and Final Cut Pro or just Motion, you want to install it here. So I have both. But if you only had Motion, like I said, you would install it here as well. So what I'll do is I'll type in Motion Templates in Finder, and I have to drag this entire folder inside of Titles, the Titles folder. So the 20 Creative Lower Thirds, drag that inside of Titles. So once I do that, they'll be in here. So let me close this, reopen it. So go ahead and open up Motion. All right, so on the left-hand side, just look for the title of the folder that you just dragged into the Titles folder. So as you can see, mine is here, Final Cut Titles 20 Creative Lower Thirds. So I'll select that and scroll down to one that I want to use. So I like this one. So I'll click that and go ahead and click open. All right, so this is how it is right now. So I just press the space bar to play it. And the good thing is this animates out as well. So just playing on the loop. So what I wanna do is up at the top left, it's on library by default. You wanna click inspector. So this will show you the things that you should be changing. So I'm gonna change this to Marshall Fox and do content creator. Was in all caps originally, but this is fine. And it has a nice grading here, but I want to change this to my colors. So open up my style guide here and I'm going to copy these two hex codes here. Paste that. Rune, I'll copy that hex code. Yep. So that looks good to me. I'll actually make this a little darker. There we go. I like that better. Yeah, that looks good. All right, so don't forget this step, y'all. We have to position this in the lower left corner or wherever you want to position this lower thirds on your video. So you'll want to come over here where it says position global and you'll want to tweak these. So I'm just moving it over. Just adjust the X and Y values. And you can also make it a bit smaller by using this scale slider, okay? or larger. I think I like it about this size. And I'll just move it over some and move it down some. I think that looks good. So now we'll export it. So I'll come over to here, top right, click share, and then click export movie. The good thing is when you download these templates, especially for motion, they're already in the right format, right? So as you can see, we need it to be an MOV file. So down here it says .mov. So we're good there, but let's just double check the settings. It's 1920 by 1080, which is fine. Video and audio, that's cool, but it's no audio. We'll just leave that. Color channels, color plus alpha. Alpha is the transparency. So that's exactly what we want. Render, we'll just leave all of that the same. And then hit next. Just save this download. So we'll just do Marshall Fox lower third. Export out. Boom, there it is. So when you play it, it'll have a black background, but when you drop it into Ecamm, it won't. So you can bring your overlay into Ecamm in one of two ways. You can just drag it in from the finder. There it is. I like the placement of it. Or you can select the new animated overlay button in the overlays panel. Select it that way. So either way, it's up to you. So what I like about this is you can select different playback options. Of course, you want it to autoplay, but when finished, you can have it do nothing, hide, or loop. So if you loop it, it'll just play over and over. But this isn't ideal for a lower third, but let's say you had some type of other animation that you created or you added in. Let's say it's from Canva or something, where you just have some subtle movements on your video or an animated background, then you can use this loop feature for that. That way you can keep your file size down and you can just keep looping the video over and over. Of course, you want it to be like a seamless loop, right? Not nothing with any sudden movements, but this is helpful for that. All right, y'all. So this is just the very tip of the iceberg. You can use this same technique for lower thirds, titles, and transitions. And if you're interested in some tutorials that are a little more advanced, check out my brand new YouTube channel. That's where I'll be sharing tips, tools, and tech for graphic designers, live streamers, and work from homies, as I like to say. And that's where I'll be dropping my full office tour, lighting setup, and other behind the scenes type of stuff. But if you like this video, please like, comment, and subscribe, and make sure you hit that notification bell so you can be notified when more videos drop. Peace.